Generals, gentlemen.
Okay, welcome back to some League of Legends Generals, Gentlemen Championship game number 2. I am Squizmar of the Generals, Gentlemen, and from Q-Dale.
And I am Unwritten Machine of the Generals, Gentlemen. So we have, on the left-hand side, we have Team Swag. So we will have Barrel of Goon as our Lux, Damix as our Thresh, Patch Face as the Nautilus, Harry as the Riven, and lastly, 2K as our Ezreal.
Yes, and on the red side is SK Telecom as Psychologist, as Ziggs in the mid lane. We got Raiden playing Lucian, Rigged playing Leona as support, Rhymey in the top lane on Kayle, and Sneaky Devil as the jungler.
They missed those grabs, unfortunately. Sneaky Devil will live to see another day, I think. Yeah, both Death Sentence and Dreadline and Light Binding. No, it hasn't actually leveled that. Well, they missed those grabs, and that was a bit of a blow there, because they could have, I think, they could have killed Rammus if I actually landed those. Rammus is pretty tanky, but, I mean, level 1, like, not so much.
Yeah, definitely be able to open up some... Oh, get that extra gold. But Team Swag is quite good in these ganks. They've
Raiden actually... may get caught here, if not Rigged. They're moving in to get these engages, actually. Oh, he got it with the Death Sentence, and now the follow-up damage will be enough to get Raiden, actually. Psychologist throwing some bombs in the back lines, in the front lines. Raiden's incredibly low. The Ignite is taking Tuca, though. He's getting a lot of damage taken onto him. Pops the barrier out of that one. Harry, though, going in onto Psychologist here, throwing bombs left, right, and center. Rigged actually getting a stun onto Harry. Now, Harry's pretty low, but they will disengage from this one. Damix may get taken out here. Tuca is very low, and somehow no one died.
What an exciting early game. That was pretty cool. Unfortunately, people have to back off and might be a bit late coming to lane. No proper leash coming for Nautilus there. Damrek's doing some sneaky Death Sentence plays there. But yeah, it was unfortunate. Everyone have to back off and people just didn't see us. So there we go. Blue cleared out before Nautilus's red. But yeah, not many interesting items coming out.
What do you think about Lux versus Ziggs in the mid lane?
I think Ziggs has a little bit more of the advantage, because he doesn't have to land, Ziggs has a little bit more of the advantage. He's going to throw his Qs out, and when Lux throws out his abilities, he can throw that out and just sidestep it. But in saying that, Lux probably did the exact same thing. His auto attacks are just stronger, because he doesn't actually have to land an ability.
Barrel of Goon's incredibly low, flashes for the bomb, but the barrier actually! Psychologist, what are you doing? You took 2 tower shots, and that'll be a first blood for Barrel of Goon. Way too greedy there from a Psychologist.
Yeah, he was doing well. He definitely won those trades, but he just wanted to flash under the turret.
And get 2 tower shots.
Yeah, that was all his summoners gone.
2K actually getting a fair bit of damage, though. The follow-up from Raiden's a fair bit. The exhaust will slow him down, and giving Raiden the chance to get more auto-attacks, but Rigged gets the kill.
I think they just didn't want him to go away. He just didn't want to get the, give away the kill, just for an escape. Yeah, Barrel of Goon.
Oh, nice dodge from Sneak Devil. The Light Binding won't connect, and with the red buff and the taunt, Barrel of Goon having to burn the flash.
Yeah, he didn't burn that earlier when he was in the Psychologist duel, but yeah, Psychologist unfortunately threw that pretty hard. Yeah, he doesn't have to land his abilities to be able to do more damage.
Damix is taking a lot of damage as well. This is a very fast game. Damix are going for the grab to get some damage onto tower. So yeah, what were we saying about the mid lane where... Yeah, I guess the advantage that Psychologist has is he can just throw, like, the barrels, his bombs over minions, where you can do the same with Lucian Singularity, but Lightbinding, you can't really go through minions unless you only hit one of them.
Yeah, you pretty much, the minion line doesn't really affect him too much, but you also have to land your abilities onto Ziggs to be able to get the passive of Lux's procs through.
But Ziggs is free, basically.
Yeah, it's just an auto attack, and if he actually lands more auto attacks and abilities, the cooldown resets quicker, so... it's more beneficial for Ziggs. So, here we go, nice trade there. Tuca, unfortunately, I'm not as trade as well as Raiden right now. And so that's that level 2, level 3 level differences.
Yeah, and now we do see Patchface going in for a gank onto Rhymey. Nice stun as well from Harry. Rhymey's looking pretty bad here. Slowed down and the Ignite taking for the kill. Patchface picks up that one.
Again, Rhymey was overextended, unfortunately. But, he was ahead of CS, but not anymore. This Nautilus... going for, I believe that was his first gank? Yes. First gank of the game, and got a kill out of it. Great job, Nautilus.
Sneaky Devil going for his second gank again with the double buffs, and no flash, but gets the snare, but not in time to disrupt that. The satchel charge actually backfired for Psychologist, knocking Barrel Lagoon towards her turret rather than backwards.
Yeah, he had a little bit more time to like load that up. When he taunts, they can't actually walk since Ramus is right next to him. But yeah, a little bit more like clutch plays, a bit more carefully precise movements. For Ziggs could have picked that up for him.
Yeah, I reckon. If the satchel charge, not only was it too soon, it disrupted the taunt, but also if it was the right direction, it could have been a kill because there was no collapse. No. Barrel Lagoon definitely in a bit of trouble there, but for now, nice dash from Raiden, avoiding that death sentence. Ricky doing a bit of damage with his Mystic Shot. Ricky actually going deep into the scene here. Chuka peeling quite well with that the Arcane Shift.
Yeah, great job there. Unfortunately, it was just a little too far away for Raiden to be able to follow up, and the trade didn't look too bad for them. But there's more minions actually for Tuka's, the blue lane, Team Swag. So they actually took a lot more minion shots than what Team SK took.
Yeah, so Barrel Lagoon is pretty weak in this lane, could get taken out pretty fast. The Psychologist is near 6, but he's kind of low on mana, so he couldn't really pop his Mega Inferno Bomb if he dinged 6, which is a shame, because he could actually land a kill, I think, if he lands that combined with a bouncing bomb. So for now, he might have to back off, if not get the blue buff when Sneaky Devil gets it when it comes up soon.
Well, he's just to really like zone and keep Lux back, and just really get as many auto attacks as he can without being super overzealous, as he usually has been. in the mid lane.
It's one way to put it. But yeah, they're even on CS because they both have such safe long range farming on bombs versus the Elusive Singularity. They're really just sort of safe long distance farming, doesn't require extending. Sneaky Devil power balls, but through a ward. So it's Team Swag. They know what's up in that bottom lane, but Barrel Lagoon will recall just in time. Sneaky Devil actually, I think, is going to gank through Tribrush.
I wonder if SK know that Patch Face is just waiting there, just chilling.
Oh, yeah, well, I didn't realize that. So that could definitely turn around
if
they go for a gank.
Yeah, he's looking back off now, yeah.
Yeah, Sneaky Devil backing off before that's going to happen. So far, it's a bit of a 1k gold lead for Team Swag. Here, not really a lot of difference. Basically, the kill, I think, is what's making up a lot of that difference there. And in the top lane, we see a bit of a farm increase onto Harry, 38 against 31 with the double Doran's and even the Doran's shield.
Yeah, they're picking up that just for the early game harass.
Going in with the Dark Passage there, but didn't quite land the death. It was Rigid to get back out of this one. It's actually pretty tanky with that shield.
Yeah, that was not too bad. They didn't go too bad, then Patchface went back off, not being able to get the actual target of Raiden, I believe. That would have been it. Picking up that blue for Psychologist, that's going to look really strong against Barrel Lagoon, but he does have this Chalice, so his actual damage output isn't going to be as powerful as what Lux has.
Oh, Damex flaying away the Zenith Blades. There wasn't actually a stun, because the stun comes from like the melee auto attack.
Yeah.
So, nice reaction from Damex.
Yeah, he's doing a great job. I really did. Props there. Quite carry down with George Rhymey landing that Reckoning, but not be able to follow up too many auto attacks afterwards. Is that a blue? Does he go?
Oh, the top lane?
Yeah, is it?
No, I think it's the buff from Divine Blessing, like the one that gives them more speed, I think, unless it's the buff from...
No, it's Mana Potion.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it just looks kind of... Yeah. Is that really...
It is blue, but that's not blue buff.
So yeah, it's not the blue part.
Well, a Patch Face standing under a ward, and Psychologist revealing his location, or revealing that he knows he's there, which, like, sometimes you don't want to do, because it means that, like, the jungler just sort of sits there wasting XP. Damage actually may get focused. He gets the stun and some damage from Raiden. Raiden's pretty low on mana, so can't really focus. Billy's actually Solar Flare being popped and having to burn the flash, but not landing the death sentence in return. So this game is slowing down now after a pretty crazy early game.
Yeah, everyone's just hit level 6 now, but they're not really trying to commit. They're trying to look for something big to everyone use it on. No globals have been used from either Lux or Ziggs yet, so I don't know what's up yet. Ziggs did a pretty good job in farming up, but...
Blade of the Exile, but I think he flashed out of it.
Yeah, he did flash out of that one, so it was a great job avoiding that. That would have been a death of Sneaky Devil.
I think so.
There.
He was pretty low.
It was quite low there. But yeah, the bottom lane, everyone, it's just a little bit ahead toward Team Swag's favor. Both mid laners and ADC is just having a little bit ahead, as well as Riven, so it's not doing too great for SK, but we've seen a couple of good plays coming out. Even if they zone Ezreal as much as they possibly can in the bot lane, he can still use his... Pulse of Fire to
Mystic
pick it
Shot.
Up. Mystic Shot to pick it up. That's his skins.
Use his skin to farm. So why Harry is not looking too strong, because they're both kind of weak, but I think it's more important for Harry because of the Lord of the Long Range damage with the Righteous Fury. But they were going in for a gank. Harry's burned everything. The Taunt will lock check down, flashing for the damage on Rhymey, and that will be a kill. So that's going to be fantastic there for Rhymey.
I believe he got spotted out by the ward, but that speed of Rams is just too much to be taken out. That ward's actually just expired in the river. So it was a great pickup then before. But when Sneak Devil came in gank earlier, I don't know why, he taunted Patchface over Harry. So I don't really know. I think he tried like reducing the amount of CC, which Patchface can deal out.
Yeah, they may even lose his top turret here. Rhymey's pretty good at shredding turrets with her Righteous Fury if she pops it. But Patchface coming back into the lane, maybe they defend this one. Probably not by the looks of it. Probably the Tremors as well.
Yeah, Tremors does more damage to targets as well.
Okay, interesting.
Yeah, as soon as the Tremors hits the champion,
it takes aggro.
Yeah. So, good job of Patchface coming up and defending that turret.
Whoa, actually, in the mid lane, crazy engagement. Psychologist barely losing that one. Barrel Lagoon pretty low, but we'll take the victory plate that time around.
Yeah, I'd really wish we saw that. I was unfortunate. Lux coming out ahead on 3 kills, 0 deaths, and winning in the CS department. So I'm pretty sure she has the most amount of gold right now. It makes sense.
Ooh. Lux.
Yeah, Lux. 4k.
Well, Culling actually being fired to clear minions, I guess. Didn't really get any impacts. True Shot Barrage will basically do something similar, so I'm really not sure why they use those ultimates. They don't really need to.
Oh, they're both out of mana right now, looking both to
Ah, yes. Yeah. Okay, that'd be why. So they can burn their ults, recall, and just go home.
Yeah, I think that's it. And Lucian sort of got the advantage by recalling first now. I think Ezreal might take that lane and actually recall, and hopefully they get back in time to stop them from doing so, because that could be very devastating. But yeah, Lux picking up that Ninja Large Rod. When she hits abilities, they're going to hit real hard. Psychologist going for that Athene's Rush again, quite a common pickup while they're going for the Death Cap, so it's trading like more amount of spells coming out and resistances for the amount of damage coming out. So if when Lux does land abilities, it's going to be a lot more devastating for when compared to when Ziggs lands his.
Yeah, well now Raiden and Rigid are back into this lane, so they can start pushing minions down as well. And Ezreal actually going for a early Triforce by the looks of it with his Sheen and his Fade. I mean, Triforce is awesome on Ezreal because it means that not only does it proc the on Mystic Shot, but it also does the damage with auto attacks. So it really gives a lot of extra power to his Mystic Shot, so he can trade and even just farm a lot better. In like actual engagements, you probably want to have more AD over Triforce, but it means that the Mystic Shots are incredibly powerful. It
makes his auto attacks be more beneficial because of that procs of what the Sheen does.
And Mystic Shot as well.
Yeah. Sorry, the Mystic... Oh, I keep forgetting that Mystic Shot actually does on-hit effects. But yeah, Lucian also looking to rush the Trinity Force as well. Ooh, and that's a... Patchface in the
will
brackets.
Be a gank here as a Patchface moving in, hasn't popped the dredge line, did it, he's waiting for rain. Solar Flare was nice, locked down all three of them. Culling didn't quite find its mark, but it will definitely disengage. That Solar Flare was very nice.
Yeah, it was pretty good. It's pretty stop this, but Team Swag might look for a dragon right now since they're all chilling there. Yeah, dragon, what did I say, Baron for?
Yeah, well, they may actually interrupt this, though. They're going for the invade on the dragon. Nicky Devil has his smite available, and so Team Sway actually backing off this one. Rigid's going to get focused, misses the light binding, though. A bit of a blow there. Barrel of Goon, but we'll use the dredge line as well, but burning everything on the support. Leona, Psychologist, will grab... Daxon will grab Psychologist. Nicky Devil, actually, will be focused now, but again, it's the Rammus. They don't want to focus the Rammus, but they don't have a choice by the looks of it. Meanwhile, Harry getting pretty low, but in this dragon fight, Tuka finally kills Nicky Devil, and that may open up the dragon because there's no more smite.
Yeah, it was a good back and forth with their focus between Team Swag there. They were focusing
way too early.
A bit early there.
But, I don't think he had vision, so yeah.
Yeah, there's no vision, it was just blind at all. Yeah, the pools of Thresh and Nautilus are crazy. And with Lux being the worst.
Wow.
Right in the corner of that box there.
Yeah, popping the box actually slowed him down. Tuka over the wall. Final Spark landed. The Kuwa secure kill. True Shot Barrage almost dead, and now Raiden may just get dived here. Tuka's going really deep under the tower. Raiden actually may finish him off in time. Patchface gets the kill onto Rigid. Tuka picks up the one onto Raiden. So a dragon and 3 kills. That is a huge victory there for Team Swag.
Yeah, in that whole time, Kayle's been pushing that top lane down. Absolutely wrecking Riven. And nothing's to do there. Psychologist was pushing that mid lane, but unfortunately not enough. Bot lane, tower, first turret to the Team Swag. they have a lot of gold really early already. It's a 4K gold deficit.
Yeah, gotta say, not looking good for SK Telecom. And keep in mind, this they're one game down. So if they lose this game, they'll be out of the tournament. This is the best of three grand final. The Rami picking up the blue buff is going to be fantastic because she needs the blue. And also it means that Team Swag don't have it. Stinky Devil going in, but deciding to back off. Don't want to go into that one by himself.
Yeah, that's going to be a huge devastation for Lux, since she has actually no regen items again. So she's relying on that blue buff to give her mana. So we might see a Chalice coming out for Lux, just so for the next team fight she actually has like some kind of prolonged ability. Oh no, she's going straight for that death cap. Yes.
Yeah.
If she misses a couple of skill shots, if SK like kind of delay this team fight and wait for Barrel of Goon to waste a bunch of abilities, I don't know. It might swing towards SK and she won't be able to carry as hard. But in the top lane, Kayle has a lot of gold on her. She's doing very good top and trying to like minimize this Riven as best she can. So I think they might try invest their time in getting Kayle kind of fed or farmed over Ziggs. Ziggs can really farm himself.
Harry going in for Rami with the Blade of the Exile, and Venture being popped as well. Has to burn the flash, so Harry really bullying that engagement there for now. Both the ults have been popped. Just uses the ult to get the minions, might as well timed out anyway. But Rami does have the heal with the blue buff for the mana and the cooldown, so he should be fine.
Definitely. Oh yeah, using the ultimate there to clear the minions. Thanks, Ziggs. Grab them. He's getting that Fiend straight up again. No surprise there. Oh, and looks like Riven's looking to do some lane swap coming into the mid lane.
Rami is incredibly fast at clearing minions with their splash damage. He took out the whole wave in just a matter of seconds. And so Team Swag are really trying to push down this mid tower, but they just simply can't.
Yeah, they don't have any opportunities. Ziggs has a good minion clear, so there we go. Reckoning getting that carry, but comes back into it. Will Rami out of... No, does not have the...
Oh, Patchfire's going in, actually. Does land the dredge line, and that will keep Rami at bay. With a stun as well from Harry. Sneaky Devil going in with a power ball, will knock up Harry, and warning him as well. The death charge going on to Rami. Sneaky Devil's incredibly low, though, but he's going to flash with his defensive ball kill and a frame. His last kill, final spark, and the light binding actually landed. Lucian's Deadly didn't quite pop in time. Harry going in with the stun. Now he's under tower by himself. Barrel Lagoon flashing for the shield. Didn't quite save him in time now, but Sneaky Devil may taunt him under tower. Barrel Lagoon being incredibly greedy here, taking, what, 4 tower shots? Solar Flare actually landing, and the Zenith Blade for the follow-up. Sneaky Devil moving in with the power ball. That may be a dead Lux here, but actually, the passive from Lux almost got the kill. He taunted him when the...
Psychologist and Raiden actually pretty low. They probably should not fight this. Tuka is low in mana, but that doesn't mean Jack... Shiz.
Yeah, we can see those mystic shots are pretty powerful. One thing I want to mention actually is, I mean, look at the cooldown on Death Charge, 126 seconds at level 1, and that's a long cooldown.
Yeah, it's quite devastating. Knocks so many people up. Like, imagine that with Yasuo. Like, get a whole team knock up just from Patch Face, or I don't know, we might see it. There we go.
So Cole is burning his flash. I don't know if it was necessary. But yeah, I mean, this whole time, Rami is just farming up pretty strong. 124 CS, not quite as much as the mid laners or the 80 carries, but still more than our Riven here. So she's farming what she can, and may even try and go for blue, a ward blue at least.
It's coming back shortly, I'm pretty sure. It nearly has been 5 minutes since the last one was stolen. It does not want to give that to Lux. If Lux gets it, she's going to be so powerful.
Oh, Defton has actually made land Raiden relentless pursuiting out of that one. The tower may get focused here, but again, the minion clear from the Ziggs is actually nuts. Sneaky Devil going in with the power ball, as once again, Rami is trying to split push down that top lane as Harry is going to meet her. So that kind of prevents them from pushing this tower in a, you know, because Harry is moving away, but they have to, otherwise they will lose the top turret.
Yeah, you don't want that. Quick Silver Sash can get picked up for a Riven quite early. I think that's just really get that Reckoning taken away, or even the Taunt.
May almost get the Taunt onto Barrel of Goon. Yeah, I gotta say, because Swag like are definitely in the lead. They've got those extra gold, the extra kills, but they just can't push these turrets. They can't capitalize on that because of the minion clear of not only this, but also made of Brain actually, yes. Yeah, so Solar Flare going in, did play back to Devil, and he will land a new taunt onto Barrel Good. Mega Bomb actually looks very powerful by the looks of it. Psychologist is quite weak, runs for his life. Harry is very low, but Devil They're all so low, backing away. I'm surprised only Barrel of Goon and Raiden not died in that one.
Yeah, it was a 4v5, actually. Ezreal still playing the bottom lane in this. Rhymey not getting enough auto attacks out.
Oh, wow, yeah. That was not bad at all. But Rhymey getting caught by the Death Sentence. Patchface actually going in as well. The play, well, not triggered, but Rhymey getting the kill with a Reckoning. And look, Harry, gotta be careful. His Bouncing Bombs can maybe finish him off. Tuka will probably back away from this duel with Rammus.
Yeah, he doesn't want to fight Rammus and lose it, but he can really kite a bunch low. But yeah, a lot of farm now still. Wow, Zix on a crazy amount right now. 178. Unfortunately, has no kills, but that's still a fair amount of CS. Yeah,
probably because it was such a like an extended tower push that during that tower, he was just farming constantly. The dragon is now available, and I think like pushing these towers is just not a good idea for Team Flood because they just can't. I mean, going for like the dragon and maybe trying to like bait out a Baron, getting a kill, and then actually taking the Baron would be a better choice.
Well, it's only got all the bottom turrets. They don't have anywhere else, and like it's either push bottom or push top, and it's much better to push mid at the moment because they're closer to dragon. They can put someone up, go to top, try to pull some pressure up there, but since I think they saw Kayle running up to the top lane from the ward.
Yeah, must have been
jungle.
Nice ward. But also, even Sneaky Devil as well getting his red buff will open up the dragon for the tanking. I mean, I think they're going to try and... No, going for mid turret. A good trade, actually. You can have the dragon. We'll take the mid turret. Final spark. Looks like Landis Mark there, actually. See, Davis going balls deep. One thing that's distant onto Raiden. Fantastic. The True Shot arrives with a follow-up. The snare from Lightbinding will lock him down. Harry getting the kill with the Blade of the Exile. Now, they're going to chase down a Psychologist, but a Rig is actually caught in the wrong side of the jungle here.
Yeah, it's fine. Can you just turn down the sound a little bit?
The sound?
Yeah, the master volume. Just a little bit, please.
Go. Thank master you. Volume down, and the blue has respawned, but looks as though this middle turret will get taken down. So they've been wanting to take that, and they had to kill Raiden to do so because he was helping clearing the minions. And now, look, the red team look out of position. They may even go for this turret. Is Iggy Devil getting a nice taunt off the patch face here, but they will disengage from this one. Damage getting focused here, flashes out of that one. Death Charge actually will lock down Rhymey.
Not even away from the Satch Charge of Psychologist there. They're really trying to go for that White Harry, but he's got his Qs available in his shield, so he won't be able to catch him. So, unfortunately, they're going to have to disengage. But, yeah, both supports grabbing their Talmud of Ascension and Doran shield. Since they're both melee, I think a common build we see with melee supports is that you get the Talmud shield and the Doran shield just to mitigate that like damage which you take from auto attacks when you go into engage with people.
Yeah, I do really like the Talisman because it means that, well, for Team Swag at least, that they can pop that Talisman and then just get in range to land, you know, either the Death Charge, the Death Sentence, or, you know, the Light Binding. As for Team Red, our good old SK Telecom, then at least it means that they could probably land the Soul of Flare, just really trying to initiate hard. It's not like they really need the Talisman for Rammus. I mean, he can initiate fine with his Powerball, but landing like a really sort of clutch Soul of Flare can really kind of shake things up and land the important CC that enables that initiation as a result here. So the game is sort of slowing down for now. I really gotta say that SK Telecom are doing a fantastic job of holding on,
yep,
despite being behind in gold.
Yeah, they're trying to do the best they can. Lucy, unfortunately, he doesn't have a BF sword, where in the other case, Ezreal has his BF sword, so his overall damage will just be so much greater than what Lucian's will be. So Ezreal's much more of a key component of what Swag is compared to what Raiden is to SK at this moment. And everyone's just doing a bit of a ward control, getting control of buffs and jungle. And Ezreal again in the bot lane, just looking to push it and probably rotating into the mid lane or follow up with the support.
He's looking very strong, 206 CS, that's more than our Ziggs here. He's got a lot of items, he's got his Triforce and he's going for a Bloodthirster as well, having to Arcane Shift overall. Don't want to get caught by Rigged there, but in the top lane, Rhymey and Patchface sort of dealing it out for now. And I'm surprised this out of top turret is still here.
Yeah, Rhymey's doing a great job in defending that. I think in the early game stages, they just couldn't really dive hard enough underneath them, but they're doing a bit of a split push, either try to save the top or try to save the bottom.
Two of the members are in the top lane. If they go for a 4v3, oh, that's a nice solar flare there. That will lock them down. The Culling is what going in, as well as that Inferno Bomb. The box will slow them down for now. Raiden a lot down from the back lines, though. Tuka as well, he's pretty powerful. He didn't quite get focused. He's almost taking out Raiden. Rigged as well is quite low. The play will knock back Rigged, maybe for the kill. One more auto attack. Tuka Tuca picks up that one. Psychologist throwing bombs at Damage, but can't quite land. Tuca ripping through a Psychologist. And in the top lane, they got the outer turret and perhaps even the inner. So nice work there from Team Swag.
Yeah, Team Swag might go to them right now. Unfortunately, they did some miscommunication there, or there was some timings off. But,
Damage gets shut down. Tuca as well. The Taunt is ridiculous, and that may be a triple kill here for Raiden. Relentless Pistol. What? Nope, just kidding. Tuca takes him out. The Sneaky Devil and Tuca not looking too good. The Taunt will secure that kill. But again, at what cost? This inner turret might be taken out. Rami going in Dredge Line didn't quite connect. Blade of the Exile wasn't too powerful because Rami was on a lot of health, but that inner turret looked like he'd taken out.
Yeah, using that Quicksilver Sash to remove the Slow of Reckoning in the debuff there. Oh yeah, getting the Zenith Blade onto Patchface on the turret. Unfortunately, no turret shots on the Reckoning followed by Rami there.
Patchface is way too tanky with the Randuins and the Spirit of the Ancient Golem. You can't focus him.
More slows.
Yeah, at least not with the entire team. So Team Swag, a very interesting decision going for like a split push with two members, but it worked for them. They got a lot of kills, and that inner turret in the bottom lane and the outer turret in the top lane as well.
Yeah, in this game, we saw Patchface run the mobility boots on Nautilus. This game is running the Merc Treads, so he's actually picking up the extra tenacity. I don't believe it actually stacks with the Golem tenacity, so I think he's just really got it for the magic resist. Built in, I'm not 100% sure.
Yeah, you're right, it doesn't stack with it, so that seems like an interesting choice going for both of them.
Yeah, but you see even more magic resist coming out, so they clearly see Ziggs and Kayle as threats in the upcoming team fights, because they just shred them and if they come too close. I don't believe they consider Lucian too much of a threat right now, considering he does not have a BF's Bloodthirster, what that Ezreal does. Just doing some free farm down bot lane, he's 40 ahead of Lucian. And
yeah, I mean, look at that AD difference. Like, there's 192 on Raiden,
yep.
And looking at Tuca, there's 275. So, you know, Ezreal here, Tuca, he has way more attack damage than what Raiden has.
Yeah, and his Q can also still get on-hit effects, while Raiden does not have that ability.
Mm.
And it's a lot longer range, while also Ezreal can split push. So there's a bit more versatility of what Ezreal can do right
now.
Yeah,
I mean, the Triforce will help out his passive, but not his light binding at all. And so going the Talisman, but didn't really capitalize on it. And so now SK Telecom are out of their Talisman.
Yeah, there's so much ward control going out. Don't we have really spoken about this Thresh going around, throwing...
Ooh, here we go. Sneaky Devil in the back lines will land onto Tuca and the Solar Flare as well, and the Mega Bomb. That's going to be a dead Ezreal with a Bouncing Bomb, and there is the Dredge Line onto Psychologist, not in time. Rami getting focused by the final spot, but the Intervention was there in time. Harry getting focused with the Taunt there, but he's going to kill by the looks of it. Rigged wants to get the kill, but the box will slow down SK Telecom. And now Patchface is going to get taken out unless he can Dredge Line over the wall. He cannot. And that is going to be a victory here for SK Telecom, actually. Damage trying to get the tower pull into Raiden. But now that's going to be a 3-0. And probably going to get the inner turret, if not the inhib as well.
That was great work by SK. That Ram is coming in right behind and shutting down Ezreal, who is the most craziest person on the team. And then they got Riven shutting her down straight afterwards. Pretty much just stopping the amount of damage getting through their squishies. So it was really great job there.
What they need to do is just shut down Ezreal. True Shot Barrage actually gets a kill onto Rigid here and didn't quite save the inhib turret, unfortunately, but they will force them off for now.
Pretty good satchel charge there by Psychologist. So low, but possibly saving Kayle there.
Was there a final spark onto a Psychologist?
Yeah, just
oh, yeah, it was.
Oh, will he get
away? Actually. Barrier Lagoon's a low on mana though, she can't really do much. The barrier did save her.
Yeah, it actually did save her there. And it was, that barrier is actually so handy in Barrier Lagoon. She takes that instead of the Ignite. She's a bit more of a passive play, but Team Swag looking to start the first Baron of the game.
Well, I think it makes sense. I mean, Lux is a fairly long range champion, and Ignite is a pretty short range ability. And so, well, keep in mind, Sneaky Devil does have the Smite to get the Baron Steel, and so Swag are actually going to disengage from it. I think I like that choice. It's a very safe thing to do. They want to throw this game. They're not exactly in the lead by much, but I think if they stayed on the Baron, that could have gone a lot sour for them.
Well, if something happens, or just say Swag gets too far ahead, SK can really get into their base and actually take out their inhibitor without them even being in their base. There's no crazy sieges coming out from that team, but it's just a possible threat.
Yeah.
So, Archon Hawks in the chat.
I gotta say, I mean, that team fight, that really was what SK Telecom needed, because now all of a sudden, they're back in the game. The gold lead previously was ridiculous, and now they're on pretty even par. If they can keep shutting down Tuca, that should be fine, because I think Tuca is what's really making a huge difference in these team fights. Getting the Dragons and giving them a little bit more of a gold lead. And actually, oh, going for Talisman with the Destiny, it doesn't quite land, though. That's a bit of a blow. Both teams popping that. Solar Flare didn't quite find its mark. Harry got caught the patch face. He's tanking everything in the front line. Starting as well, we'll lock him down, but Death Charge will prevent that from doing more damage. Final Spark was fantastic. Look at that damage there from Team Swag, taking them all down apart from Kayla because of her intervention. And now all of a sudden, Team SK Telecom not looking too good right now.
Yeah, the psychologist there. They're going to have to go back up. That was Talisman. As they sort of came back into the mid lane, they reinitiated on each other, and it was just not the greatest initiation.
Yeah, it was
Final Spark hitting a lot of people.
Well, it was Lightbinding, Vox, and Final Spark. It just shut down the team for way too long. We lose the inner turret, probably the inhib as well. So this game is, it's getting pretty close. I mean, for now, Team Swag are above in gold, about 5k gold. Baron is up for the taking, but they're too low. They're going to have to recall first, and that will give Team SK Telecom enough time to get back with all the members' full health items and up.
Who would be better between Ezreal and Lucio?
Well, I think the later the game goes, the more crucial intervention is.
Yes.
So intervention could make a pretty big difference, as we see a very clutch one to do later in the game. And somehow this outer turret is still alive in the bottom lane. Sneaky Devil isn't the ideal pushy here. The Baron is there for the taking, but I really think that these teams are going to want to try and secure a kill or two before going for the Baron, kind of blindly going for it. It's a very, very risky move. Raiden trying to go for the red, but not feeling too confident right now, is Team Swagger nearby wanting to take that one.
I think Lux will be a lot better in the late game if she gets a double snare with the Light Binding and followed by the Final Spark. That can potentially just remove two people out of the fight.
Oh, and it has done.
It has done in the past. You've seen Froggen, who's pretty good on
that. Well, I mean, in this series, we've seen Lux really rip through the teamfights with the Light Binding and the Final Spark. 2K, oh, getting very, very greedy. Don't want to be in the front, 2K. The teamfights pretty much revolve around you.
Yep.
Don't go in the front, 2K. No, don't do that. Solar Flare and the taunts can be devastating.
Yeah, it's all about Reckoning, shutting down a bit, everyone doing more damage on him. But yeah, Barrel of Goons in a pretty decent spot right now. Ready to land some Light Bindings, followed by a couple of shots by Ezreal. Derek's doing a bit of the removal with the red trinket.
Scrying Orb?
Scrying Sweeping Lens.
Ah, of course, Sweeping Lens.
Sweeping Lens.
So this team fight could be messy. Tuca, once again, trying to lead the charge. Not the best choice either, but Patchface there with it. That's what we want to see. We want to see him in the front line.
He's scary.
He is indeed. Rummy actually may get focused here. Doesn't quite pop the dredge line just yet. There we go. Raiden getting caught. Nice work. Dredge line will knock him down. Randall slowing them down for now. This team fight's all over the place here. Harry is trying to get focused by Sneaky Devil. Solar Flare locking down Damix, but we actually do see Peacemaker being taken out here. Natalia actually will take out Damix, but Raiden with the intervention will be fine for now. Rami popping the Zonyas. Rig is pretty low. Tuca taking him out just in time. And now Tuca diving under the turret here. Harry as well. Wow, where did she come from? She'll get a double kill ripping through them. And now it's only Raiden left by himself. That was a messy team fight. What happened there?
Oh man, that was not that great. Sneaky Devil targeting Barrel of Goon while the rest of her team target Tuca one. She actually wasn't, like, she went actually past Tuca and kept going down the lanes, coming back around and getting him. But besides that, they...
Oh, Raiden actually almost getting taken out by the Final Spark. They may lose one of these Nexus turrets as the rest of the team, you know, 10 seconds from respawning, and Tuca can chunk through the towers, and so this could be game over for SK Telecom here. That second turret will be next, and all of a sudden, this isn't looking too strong. I mean, there is a team that have respawned now, Rigged, Ethnic Devil with the Home Guard boots and Powerball. That is ridiculous. We'll actually catch Harry, but look at the snare from the Light Binding. Tuca getting caught by that, but look, nice quick Silver Sash will peel him for now. That's a nice work there. Mystic Arcane Shift over the wall. Nice escapes here from Tuca.
Yeah, I don't think enough though. Sneaky Devil will be able to power up again.
Oh, nice dredge line there. The Solar Flare will lock them all down. Inferno Bomb will do a bit down, but not really a lot because they are tanky. Sneaky Devil actually. The culling is pretty powerful. Can't find a target though. Sneaky Devil has survived for now. Patchface actually trying to make something happen here. Rami getting knocked up by that Light Binding, and now intervention keep him alive, and he'll help him shut down our Riven here. Raiden now running for his life. Patchface and Doom on the chase here. There we go. Sneaky Devil coming back with the Home Guard boots. but it doesn't quite find the taunt he's looking for. He wants to taunt Tuca, but look how far back he is.
I would like to see Rammus running teleport instead of flash. That would be a lot more, way more cooler. Like, just be able to, like, teleport into, like, anywhere in the lane and have that home guard buff and just be like, nyeop! And knock them up and then just taunt them, and no one can escape that. That is really scary to watch.
So this game isn't over just yet. There's no Nexus turrets, but still, SK Telecom are holding on for now.
It's over.
Baron hasn't been claimed just yet, but there is a 10k gold difference, so really not looking good here for SK Telecom, especially as they are one down. So this is a best of three in game number two. If they get taken out here, they will be removed from the tournament, and we will have our victors. Team Swag, so we're gonna have to see some pretty crazy stuff. It's gonna be hard for them to push out with these super minions in the middle lane, because they're quite strong now. I mean, as we keep saying, the buff super minions makes them very hard to deal with, because it looks as though Team Swag will get this Baron, and what can they do?
I don't believe they can do anything. If they do come fight, they most likely will lose, unless they get a really good global, a good lockup on either Barrel of Goon or Ezreal. Balagoon or Tuca, hopefully both at the same time from Leona's ultimate, so...
Sneaky Devil could have maybe stolen it here, but he's just too far away. It's getting quite low, but there's just no way for SK Telecom to invade that. And now that's going to be a Baron, you know, onto Team Swag, looking even stronger than normal. Damage actually powering up the Death Sentence. Does actually miss it, though. So does the Dread Lion. Or Death Shard, rather.
Yes.
Dredge Line.
Dredge Line, yes.
It's a tricky one, isn't it?
Yeah, they use their Talisman there, but unfortunately not very fruitful. They probably could have used it earlier, get a little bit close and be able to flay someone back and then use your Death Sentence. But they're so powerful right now, they can really just bully themselves into the base. Psychologists not be able to do anything. Pretty much every majority of people level 18. Oh, only one person's level 18, that's Lux. I thought Tuca was...
Yeah, Reed's level 12, and they can maybe get to Nexus. They may not even try and go for the team fight here. Tuca's finished his items, so he is full damage. Sneaky Devil going in, gets the taunt, and the top action. Nice Quicksilver Sash as well. Blue team not looking too good here, having to run away from that one. The Culling doing a fair bit of damage there. There's a lot of minions, though. So all of a sudden, Psychologist getting pulled by that Death Sentence. Curry is incredibly low, but they may go to Nexus here. It's not about half HP. Can they finish this one off here? Blue team are all so low, but the Nexus actually may get taken out here. And there is it. That is it. That is game over.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no more cast.
Yeah, so didn't quite take it into the third game. 2-0 victory here for Team Swag. So living up to their name and taking this grand final in a 2-0 sweep.
Yeah, Nautilus and Thresh just work really well together. I think that's a lot of synergy that came out of it. And just those two need to lock someone up. Lux can follow up with some CC. And either Ezreal or Riven can follow through with the execution, essentially. But it was pretty well played from SK there, but not good enough. And Team Swag, congratulations, the victors of the championship of Generals Gentlemen.
Yeah, that's right. They get
number one.
They get $50 of Riot points and the glory of winning the most important tournament in all of Australia, I think.
All of
Perth. That's what I feel, at least.
At least Perth.
Yeah, well, thank you for watching. We had a bit of a blast here. Okay. But I think we'll stop ranting now as we'll wrap this one up. So until next time, we're Generals Gentlemen. Catch you later.